In this video, we're doing a little review and walkthrough on Microsoft Tag, and we're just hoping to shed a little light on what this trendy thing is right now. An example of what a tag could be is, I'm just going to scroll down here, is you'll see it right here. It can be in multiple colors or it can be black and white. The new thing with this is you may see them on business cards, on ads, pretty much on anything that's printed or even on websites. And what this tag it allows you to do is to snap it or take a picture of it with your smartphone, and it translates to information or sends you to a website. Now, there are a couple types of tags. There's the Microsoft one. There's a QR. It's pretty easy to use and create, and it is at no cost. The nice thing about the Microsoft Tag one is that it allows you to have some nice reporting tools so that you can see what your stats are. So I'm just going to sign in. And when you sign in, it brings you to the main page for your reporting tools. It's pretty easy just to create one. You just click on create a tag. Type in whatever tag title you want and what type it's going to be. Is it going to be a URL? Are you going to provide some text like a slogan or something like a buzzword or something that you want to use for a customer to get a discount? VCard is basically the file that you can save your contact information from Outlook, and Dialer, which will enable the individual to dial your number. You've got tag notes as well too that you can add. The start date that you want this tag to be active, and when it ends. In addition, if you want, you can also plug in your URL here. So I'm just going to do one for one that goes to our website just to show you what it looks like. And it's already rendered here. Quick symbol here tells you that it's for a URL. It's got that globe symbol that it's active. And all the way to the right here, there's two columns. The render one, which you click on, and there is a little pop-up window that tells you that there's certain implementation guidelines on sizing and resolution and coloring. What you get when you bypass that screen is you get further pieces of information here where you can choose on how you want the actual tag to look and be rendered to you. So these are the previews of what they would look like if you select them with the radio button. However, what we did was we chose the Render My Tag in black and white. You can choose the actual file format that you want and also the specific sizing. I pretty much left it at the default and chose the custom function here. Once you click on the render button at the bottom here, you get a pop-up for the actual file. And I'm just opening up the PDF and there you go. That's what it looks like. Now, of course, you know, you can crop this and do whatever you want to it. It does have a really nice thing, and that is in that manual for the implementation guidelines, it shows you and walks you through how to customize it. So you can actually incorporate your logo into this MS tag, which we did at Owldesk. Or if you want to get really fancy, I think this is a great way too if you want to exchange contact information and make use of your smartphone. Simply go to a conference, a meeting or anything like that, or if you're hanging out with friends and do a personal one, and you guys can take a picture of each other's tags with your smartphones, and that will perhaps transfer your contact information. A lot easier than typing in each digit one at a time and then saving it and then entering your friend's name. All right, back to the main page here, and I'm going to click on the report button. You can choose your parameters here for the tag that you want to run the report on. And because that one we just created, there's not going to be any data. So I'm just using another one that we have here. And it gives you a nice graph that you can see in terms of the number of scans it received and the dates. Nice thing is up at the top here, you have additional selections for the output of the graph, the colors, if you want a different type of chart. You can even import it as or export it to Excel as a CSV file along with the graphics. And you can save it on your hard drive and print, so on and so forth. Basic reporting tools. Now, I've seen controversy about the use of this item, the tags, out there. So there's lots of blogging about it, whether or not it's just a fad or, you know, if it's just a waste of money and people's time. I think as we see more and more people using their smartphones to access online shopping, and smartphones are pretty much becoming everyone's portable mini computer, I don't think having tags is a bad thing. Now, some people may not know what they are, but I think eventually it'll catch on. Whether it stays around is another question. But in the meantime, I think it's a fun tool to have. Wanted to show you an example that Jessica Simpson's using for her print campaigns. I've actually seen it in some of the magazines. And she has them in her print ads with the MS tag. Again, some people are for it, some people are against it. But I think it's a lot more useful. Imagine going to a party or something, or hanging out with your friends and you meet someone. You want to exchange contact info. Yeah, you can do it through the infrared way. However, you could also do it through the tag way. Anyways, thanks for watching Owl Desk.